Good morning everyone, I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss the fourth topic of our chapter number one, that is not for profit organizations, and the name of the topic is income and expenditure account, right? So in my previous video I have discussed receipts and payment account, where we were considering all kinds of receipts and all kinds of payments, whether they are of revenue nature or capital nature. But some rules are different here in while making income and expenditure account. So let's see what are the rules of making income and expenditure account. So our first point says it is a nominal account. Why it is a nominal account? You all know that the rule of nominal account says debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. Similarly, here we just have to take expenditure as well as income for making our income and expenditure account. Next point is incomes are gains, so credited means, see, this is the format of income and expenditure account. Again, this is an account, so it will be prepared in a T format. It has two sides, debit and credit. On the debit side, we have to record all the expenditures. See, it is written here. Expenditure are expenses and losses, so it will be recorded on the debit side. It means on the debit side, all the expenditures will be recorded, right? Then incomes are gains, so it will be credited. Means on the credit side we have to record all the incomes. Okay, the difference between the two sides are termed to be as surplus or deficit. Now see, while making profit and loss account, the net results are net profit or net loss. But because income and expenditure account is specially made for non-profit organizations, so the balance they get is either surplus or deficit. So it will not be termed as net profit or net loss, because their main motive is not to earn profit, right? So their balance would be either surplus or deficit. The next and the most important point to be considered while making income and expenditure account is, it is prepared at the end of the accounting period, matching revenue receipts and revenue expenses. Even I have written here for the year ended. So income and expenditure account is to be prepared at the year end. So that is why we have to write for the year ending, right? Now the crucial point to keep in your mind is it considers revenue receipts and revenue expenses. See, you all know that there are two types of expenses basically, revenue and capital. Capital expenditures are those expenses which generates our assets, like money spent for purchase of building, furniture purchased, any motor vehicle purchased, right? Whereas our revenue expenditures are those expenses which are of recurring nature, which are happening in the year again and again. For example, rent paid, honorarium, right? Then freight paid, stationery paid. So lots of expenses are there to be considered, but these expenses must be of revenue nature, right? On the other hand, we have to consider only revenue receipts. So what are revenue receipts? For example, life membership fees, sorry, it to be considered to the balance sheet, so we will not consider it. Then entrance fees, then journal donations, again what rent received. So these kind of revenue receipts we have to take while making income and expenditure account. Now at last, what we have to do? After transferring all the expenses on the debit side, revenue expenses, then all the revenue receipts on the credit side, make a total of both sides. If expenditure side is greater, then the balance we will get deficit, right? On the other hand, if our credit side is greater than the debit side, then we will get a positive balance, which is called surplus. So this is how you have to maintain income and expenditure account. So there are some adjustments to be made in this account that I'll discuss in my next video. Till then, please practice all the questions given in your book and send me your queries. Thank you so much.